time to sing and have some fun. We're gonna hear God's word before we're done. We're gonna dance, we're gonna shout.
Hello, twos and threes. I hope you've been having a wonderful week. It's time for our big God story, and I'm so excited to get to share it with you today. Before we get started, though, there's someone we need to call up. Hamilton, right? Okay, when I count to three, let's all call him with our biggest, loudest voices we can. Are you ready? One, two, three. Oh, Hamilton, where are you? Hello, Hamilton. It's so good to see you today. Friends, can you say hi to Hamilton? Oh, I hope you've been having a, what? A great week? Oh, okay. Hamilton has something he'd like to show you guys. Would you like to see it? I think they would love to see it, Hamilton. Why don't you go get it? I wonder what Hamilton has to, oh my goodness, look at this. Hamilton, did you make this? I love it. It's a collage. A collage is when we take pictures or paper and we put them together to make a beautiful piece of art. I can tell this is important to you, Hamilton. Wow, I really like that you put spinach on your collage. That is so healthy. That is, oh, and ice cream. He also put ice cream on his collage. Thank you so much for showing us that, Hamilton. Well, we've been talking about how God takes care of us. And last week, we learned about the story of Elijah and how God took care of Elijah. So let's talk some more about that and see what you remember from last week. As we talked about, God loved Elijah so much. And Elijah, that's right, loved God. Can you guys say that with me? God loves Elijah. Very good. God loved Elijah. And do you know what else? God loves to talk to us. And God talked to Elijah. Thank you, Hamilton. God loves to talk to us, and God talked to Elijah and told Elijah something very important. Do you remember what it was? That there was not going to be any rain for a really long time. Do you remember how we talked last week? Why do we need rain? That's right, friends. The rain gives us food to eat. That's how our plants grow. It gives us water to drink. Rain is very important. And remember how we told you last week that there was a king who did not love God and who did not like Elijah? God knew the king was going to be very angry about there being no rain. And so God told Elijah to hide. And Elijah listened. Friends, we can listen to God just like Elijah listened. Elijah listened and ran and hid where God told him to. Can you guys say with me, Elijah listened? Elijah listened. Very good. Well, Elijah went to go hide, and just like God promised, there was no rain. But God took care of Elijah by showing him a stream, a brook to go and drink water from. Remember how we learned that last week, that God took care of Elijah with water to drink? But Elijah also needed food to eat, right? And so God sent some very interesting birds called ravens to feed Elijah. And those ravens brought bread and meat to Elijah to eat. Those are all ways that God takes care of us. You know, Hamilton, that kind of reminds me of your collage here. These are all ways that God takes care of us now, right? Do you guys live in a house or an apartment? Do you have a home to live in? Yes, God takes care of us by giving us a house to live in. Do you guys have a family, people who love you and take care of you? Yes, that's another way that God takes care of us. And we may not always like to eat things like spinach and broccoli, but God gave us wonderful fruits and vegetables to help us grow strong, right, friends? Absolutely. And my favorite, grandmas. Oh, I love grandmas. I'm so thankful that God gave us family and grandmas and grandpas. And transportation. We can drive a car, we can take a bus or a train to get around. That's another way God takes care of us. And what's that, Hamilton? Ice cream. Yes, and God even gives us extra special treats like ice cream and vacations and trips to the beach and park. Those are all ways that God takes care of us. I love the story of Elijah because it's a story about love, about speaking and listening and then providing. Those are all things that God does, and we can know that God takes care of us through this story and through the many things we see in our day-to-day lives. Isn't that awesome? Well, I encourage you guys to talk with your families and friends about ways that you've seen God take care of you. And do you know what you can do? You can pray and thank God, because God loves when we show thankfulness for the ways that He takes care of us. Hamilton, thank you so much for helping us today with the story. I appreciate your help. And friends, we'll see you next week for our Big God Story. Goodbye.